So today we're going to talk about plant releasing. Now what plant releasing is essentially getting rid of the weeds from around any planted areas. And now while it's a really simple thing to do, it's the most important thing you can do to ensure survival of these plants. Now before we get into tips and tricks and techniques, I'd like you to look at this time lapse and just see how quickly weeds can grow up around in a planted area. So there are some things we need to consider before we start releasing. Now there's two types of releasing. The most basic one is hand releasing, where all we really need is a pair of gloves to protect ourselves when releasing around plants. The second one, which is a bit more complex and more things to think about, is herbicide release. Now there's a lot of different ways we can do this, but we always need good gear. I always start with a good pair of goggles. These are mist-free ones so I can see what I'm doing. It'll stop spray. A very good pair of gloves, these are PVC and resistant to oil and herbicides. And a good spray mask. Now this one has a carbon filter to make sure that herbicides won't get through. Now that's the time we were at most risk is when we're filling these up with neat herbicide. So we do have a legal responsibility to protect our employees as well as each other when we're out on site doing these things. When we're filling these containers up, make sure that we do have all the gear that we need before anything starts. So there is another thing that we could use, which is a spray guard around a plant. So that will sit around the plant, close up to it, to protect any spray drift. And that's often useful in large scale restoration planting. So the simplest releasing technique is hand releasing. And it's simply that. It's getting these other weeds, grasses, from around your plant, moving them away. Taking care not to damage your plant in the process. Now this will be important for when you're spraying with herbicide as well. You do want to pull as much of that plant around away from your target tree, in this case it's a nice flax, before you can spray around. But often getting these out as well, pulling them right out of the ground, and it'll just add to mulch too for when it's going. You'll be surprised at how long this will last before weeds will start growing up again. Now you can do herbicide releasing pretty easily without a spray guard. So when we're spraying, we want to make sure we're spraying away from the plant. We want to make sure that nothing is going to hit that flax, but we are going to release around the plant. So keeping that nozzle facing this way, really important. So I'm just going to use a spray guard now. Many people will just make them out of a bit of ply or a real estate sign. But this helps us see through it today. So it's really just protecting that plant, so making sure everything's on that side of it. So having a spray guard really allows you to spray quite vigorously around the area without affecting your native plant. So just move that around, making sure that the sprayed area isn't going to touch your plant, and this way as well. So what I'm going to demonstrate now is one of my favourite tools for releasing, and it's using Selective herbicide. Now what I've got behind me here is quite common, particularly in the North Island, is vines climbing over native plants. Now those could even be planted, or in this case they're naturally regenerated. These vines I want to get rid of, but these other things, which are Carex germinata, I want to keep. Now what I can use is a selective herbicide which kills only broadleaf plants. So I can spray over top of these Carex germinata without any problem at all. They won't even have the mechanism to feel what's over top of them. But the other plants here will die away. So they'll allow these to be released and grow through. All right, let's get started. So the last releasing technique I want to show you is selecting for grasses. Now what we've got here is some sedges, but these could equally be any broadleaf plants, native broadleaf plants, and you can spray right over top of them with a selective herbicide just for grasses. It'll just kill the grasses, leave everything else behind. So you can imagine in a big planting situation, this is really going to speed up our releasing. It won't kill things like in this case we've got buttercup and other broadleaf plants, those will be fine too. But the great thing about sedges is you can actually spray both the broadleafs and the grass-specific sprays over top, just leaving the sedges. They won't absorb any of the chemical. So let's get started. So that concludes our video on releasing. Now, while it's one of the most simple things, it is the most important. So make sure you get out there and do it. It's really important to contact your regional council or local distributor, because we talked about some specific herbicides here. They're important that you use correctly and always read the label. Now, and don't forget to check out our other how-to guides, and happy releasing.